Thank you for holding. My name is Linda. Would you like to file a new report or follow up on existing?
Hello, Linda. I'd like to follow up on an existing report. I have the report number right here and the PIN.
Perfect. What is your report key, please?
All right. It is.
Thank you. I have 576. What is the password, please?
The password.
14. Information. Let me pull up your report.
Oh, why would you repeat it back? What if someone was listening?
No, I'm repeating it to make sure I have it correct.
Oh, but what if someone was listening, like behind you or something?
No, sir. We all work here. It's and required to. That's part of our process. We're required to repeat that to make sure we have it accurate.
Okay.
I've got your report number. I've got your report information here.
Okay.
It states on March 13th, it says, hello, are you sure you have the correct store location? There isn't a Brian Washington general manager at the suggested location.
Is that all it says?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I want to add on to my report, and then I want to respond to that comment.
Okay, let's go ahead. Yes, sir.
Hello?
I said, yes, sir, go ahead.
Okay, want to say that today Brian Washington dyed his member, his penis, green for St. Patrick's Day.
Okay, sir. I'm just going to put you on brief hold. Please hold, sir.
This is serious. Hello? Hello? She just hung up on me. God damn it. We'll just get another person. Oh, Brian also uses the key machine.
Thank you for calling the Lowe's Open Door Service managed by Navex Global. This is Turkisa. Are you calling to file a new report or follow up?
I have a complaint right here already. I have the ID.
May I have that number, please?
Yeah. Can I just make the request that you don't repeat it back?
Sure.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, and what is your password? Okay, that number is inaccurate.
What do you mean?
Your report number that you provided was 13 digits instead of 12. Our report numbers are 12.
Oh, hold
digits.
On. I think you might have missed a digit. One second. I'll repeat it back.
That's 13 digits.
Yeah, that's the one that they gave me. And I just used it a second ago. And it worked.
Our report numbers are 12 digits.
This is the same number that I just called.
Okay, it's telling me that this is an invalid report key and password combination, and the reason it's telling me that is because our report numbers are 12 digits.
Okay, I just called less than 10 minutes ago, and I gave them the same thing, so really makes you think, you know?
Well, sir, I'm not exactly sure what information you may have provided.
Maybe it's because, like, you don't know how to use a computer. Is that the problem?
That's probably not the problem. I do this all day, every day.
Oh, you do?
This is the number. Okay, well, the number that you've provided, it says that it's an invalid report key and password combination. I'm telling you that our report keys are 12 digits. You've provided 13, and that's the issue. That's why it's not taking this number.
Well, I think you're putting it in the wrong field. This is for Lowe's.
Sir.
I don't want to tell you how to do your job, but you're doing it wrong.
Okay. Well, sir, unfortunately, with the information that you've provided, I'm unable to locate
your report.
All right,
well, let's just open up a new report then, shall we?
Certainly.
All right, because this is a big issue I got. It's a big issue.
Just a moment.
Okay.
actually, sir, if you could you repeat that number again, please? Because I can, and the thing is, you've asked me not to repeat it back to you, but I can almost tell you what's wrong with the number that you're providing. But if you'll repeat it back to me, I can give you the information.
Okay. Oh, so now I can get my report again. All right. Here you.
Sure. What's the number? Okay. So the issue is that the first number that you gave me, you stated that it was 576-63.
No, I wasn't.
You did, twice.
No, I have an IQ of 108, so there's no way I could have done that.
I don't doubt what your IQ was, but I can tell you that you provided that number twice inaccurately, but how can I assist you today?
Okay, so did everything pop up now?
I have your report in front of me. How can I assist you?
Okay, all right. Now listen, I need to add on to the report something that happened today.
Certainly, what information would you like to add?
All right, so the first thing is I need to add on that Brian Washington is using the key machine to duplicate do not duplicate keys.
Are you aware that the company is stating that there's no Brian Washington?
Yeah, I know. I'm going to respond to that, too, after I add on to this. Don't worry.
Okay, sure.
I have a thing or two to say to them as well.
Okay.
I also need you to add on that Tarkisha, the person who I used to file this report, is creating a hostile work environment.
Could you spell her name, please?
Tarkisha, I believe that she's the person that handed you off to me.
I'm not sure, sir. No one... When I got to the phone, it was just you.
Okay, well, she works there, so at where you work. So I want to add her to the report as well, and say that she is very sassy and does not know how to use computer.
Okay.
And blames the use of her faults of using the computer on me, which is not my fault because I took two classes of computer science in university.
Okay.
Did you put that down?
I did, actually. You know how to spell her name?
It's like black spelling, like Tarkisha,
it's
probably.
Like, it's like black spelling?
Yeah, like black spelling, how black spells things.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You know what I mean.
No, sir, I have no idea what you mean.
Like how blacks spell things differently than whites, normal people?
Oh, how blacks spell things differently than normal people?
No, I don't want to say normal people, just white people in general.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's like African American vernacular English. It's just a different dialect of English, yeah.
Okay, sure, no problem.
There's that thing to be, you know, I mean, me and you, we speak, you know, normal, but they don't, you know.
They who?
You know, they.
No, they who?
They, you know, the black people who speak that way.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, I'm not aware of what you're speaking about, sir.
All right, well, that's fine, that's okay. Anyway, can I respond to what they said as well?
Absolutely.
Okay. Listen, so, I want to say that, so we'll respond, I know that Brian works there. I also need a follow-up on what, on Stephanie, as well as now Tarkisha. I know Brian is connected with the Human Resources Department, so please do not lie. Put that down.
Certainly.
And can you read everything back for me after you're done, please?
I certainly will. Just a moment.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so you said that you know that Brian works at the store and that he is connected to the Human Resources Department?
He has connections with the Human Resources Department. He used to, He used to date one of the girls who worked at the Human Resources Department. And
would you like that added to your report?
Yeah, and say that he's got, like, a lot of her nudes, so that's why they don't do anything about him. You have, like, a really, like, sassy attitude.
Okay.
Is it because, like, you're on your period right now, or what's going on with that?
Sir, I really think that if there's information that you would like added to your report, you can provide that information.
Okay.
Actually, hold one moment for me.
No. You're just going to hang up on me, I know it.
Oh, I'm not. Just hold one moment for me, please.
You're going to ask your supervisor if you can hang up on me.
I most certainly am not, if you'll
hold, please. No, you are. Just like every other woman. Hello?
Yes, sir. Hold one moment, please.
Okay. Listen, I'm drunk because it's St. Patrick's Day, okay? Did you know it's St. Patrick's Day today?
Would you like that added to your report?
Yeah, can you add that to my report?
I certainly can. Absolutely.
That I've been drinking today because it's St. Patrick's Day. And then can you read everything back to me so I know that we've got everything down, and then I'll be good. Then I'll hang up and leave you alone, because obviously I'm bothering
you. Hold one moment for me. Just let me get my notes together. Hold one moment for me.
Okay.
Thank you so much for holding and being patient. Mm-hmm. Question for you. Do you have Tarkisha's last name?
No, I don't. She works there. She just say that she works at the complaint hotline.
Okay. Well, this information goes to Lowe's, so
I understand. That's
all right.
Fine.
Well, the information that I have here is that Brian Washington is using the key machine to duplicate. Do not duplicate.
No, can you read back every single thing that's on there just so I know that nothing has been deleted by Brian?
They're not able to delete anything, sir.
I need to make sure.
To you, but, so your entire report reads. Give me just a moment.
Okay. What were you doing while I was on hold? All right, that's okay. You don't need to answer that.
So, sir, what your report reads is, this report is to document the extremely unprofessional behavior of Brian, who has been engaging in behaviors ranging from bullying to sexual harassment. Mm-hmm. Brian fought in the Vietnam War, and this seems to have affected him both mentally and physically. Brian was shot in the pancreas, which has resulted in him being an extremely heavy-set fellow.
Can you change heavy-set fellow to fatty?
I cannot change anything in that report, sir.
Oh, okay. All right, that's fine.
Brian is also extremely rude and crass, using curse words and racial slurs such as thick, round eye, and the N-word, spick.
What's the N-word? Which one is that? Are they referring to
the N-word?
Are they referring to nerd or the other N-word?
I am reading to you the exact way that it is written in your report.
Can you make
so
an amendment?
I don't know what it's referred to.
Can you make an amendment at the bottom that the N-word is referring to the word that the pejorative term for African Americans? Instead of the word nerd?
Okay, the N-word is referring to
the pejorative term for African Americans. Yep, because I just don't want people to have it confused with nerd, you know?
So then it states, Brian will say this to customers and employees alike. Brian has an alcohol problem, like when he came to work drunk on 3-2-2017. He insisted on driving the forklift and complained everyone was being too loud. The employees had to force Brian into the office. The real issue, however, is Brian's absolute addiction to pornography, specifically lesbian pornography. Brian will watch it in the office, calling employees to watch it with him. Brian then asks them to rate it on a scale from 1 to 10. 10 being the best, and the score that does not match his has to berate the employee for not knowing about porn. Brian has been seen naked in his office as well.
That's the other thing that's like, that's just crazy, right?
It has also, I can't provide my opinion, sir. It has also become a weekly routine for Brian to line up his employees and choose two at random and say they cannot leave the store until they kiss. It is always two female employees.
See, that's so chauvinist.
Towards the caller, Brian has been demeaning, calling him or her a pussy repeatedly. Once the caller did not respond how Brian wanted, and he asked if the caller thought two females were really tight. The caller would like to stress that this once occurred when a bit of dust got into the caller's eye, and the caller was not crying. It was just the dust.
Can you have that underlined?
I cannot. Okay. While the matter is being looked into, the caller would also like to note that Stephanie is contributing to a hostile work environment. The caller wants to ask Stephanie out, and she said that the caller was not her type. Stephanie's refusal to go out with the caller contributed to the hostile work environment. The company is encouraged to look into and correct this situation.
Are you okay?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Now, can you continue?
That actually is the end of your initial report.
Okay, yeah, now read the rest of all the amendments and everything.
Okay. So the caller wants to add on that Brian likes to mix vodka to his 7-Up. It's his 7-Up can when he is doing rounds around the store.
I just want to clarify, like, this is just a personal note, but that's actually a really efficient way to do it, because then people don't actually know that you're drinking. I do that a lot.
Okay. On one occasion this week, he threw it into the customer's face when the customer accused him of drinking. Brian was also seen smoking cigarettes in the women's restroom. Brian does not like to use the restroom because he says there's too many dicks in there. Brian also nudges someone while making the statement. The caller also wants to add Stephanie is known to have a resting bitch face. Then it says, let me see, what else did you add here? The company responded on 3/7. Thank you for submitting your concerns for review. Employee relations is a part of human resources and has the responsibility for investigating such matters. I am Dante Childress, employee relations consultant. Would you be willing to speak with me so that I can obtain additional information? My contact number is 949-244-6000. It states, the caller wants to know if Dante is male or female. The caller prefers to speak to Infanderi. And then you have here, hello, are you sure that you have the correct store location, as there isn't a Brian Washington general manager at the suggested location? The information that you added today. Just a moment. One moment. There is one thing here.
Hello?
One moment.
Are you typing something?
I am.
Oh, what are you typing?
One moment, I'll read it to you.
Okay. Are you writing something about me, like how I'm a bad person?
I am not.
Okay. Is there any way that we can add emphasis that it was that the caller wanted the part about the dust underlined so that no one knows, so that, you know, I wasn't, just so everyone knows that I wasn't crying?
Sure.
Okay. Is there a way that we could also, like, say that we wanted it bolded as well?
If that's what you would like for me to do?
Yes, please. It's just important to me. Like, you know how dust sometimes can get into your eye, right?
No.
It makes you look like you're crying, but you're really not, you know?
No, I've never had that issue, so just a moment.
Okay. But it does happen, so it don't discount it. Hello?
Just a moment.
Okay. How long is a moment? Can I get like an actual time frame estimate?
I don't have a time frame.
Oh, because I really want to go back to drinking after I'm done with this call.
You're more than welcome to disconnect whenever you'd like, sir.
I'll wait for everything to be finished, of course. I mean, I've already held down for 24 minutes. I could do 24 hours at this point.
Oh, no problem.
Would you get paid overtime if we did that?
Sir?
Hi. Is it ready?
I'm sorry?
Is it ready?
No.
Is it almost done? Are you almost done?
Sir, if you need to go, you can disconnect, and if you would like to do this to submit this information online, you can do that as well.
Oh no, I'd rather do it through you because you've been very helpful today. I'm just gonna start drinking while on the phone, okay? Which part are you at? That's okay, you don't need to answer that. Or that either.
Here's a Brian Washington is using the key machine to duplicate, do not duplicate keys. Tarquisha is sassy and does not know how to use a computer. The caller stated that he knows that Brian works at the store and has connections with the human resources department, and that the company and asks that the company please do not lie. The caller stated that Brian has nude photos of a representative in human resources, which is why the company will not do anything to Brian. The caller would also like to inform the company that the caller has been drinking because it's St. Patrick's Day. The N-word is referring to the pejorative term for African American, and the caller stated that mixing vodka into his 7-Up can is an efficient way to drink while at work because the caller has done this before. The caller wants to underline and bold the section in the initial report that states that dust was in the caller's eye to be sure that it is made known that the caller was not crying.
Okay. I think that that's basically it. Can you add on there that I only drink if I'm on forklift shift because then no one can see me doing it if I'm up like top?
Sure.
Okay. That way they can't see me, because if I'm all the way above the shelves. The game I like to play is what I'll do is I'll take a sip every time I reverse. That way I won't get, you know. Because if I'm reversing while doing it, I'll adjust to being in motion when I'm
Okay,
drunk.
and how often do you do this?
Every Friday, usually.
Okay.
Every time I hear the beep, usually I'll take like a quick sip. Sometimes. That's only if no one else is working that day. Can we just also clarify that I want to remain anonymous about this stuff, and that this
you
is all
remain anonymous.
And that can you stress that this is all hypothetical? I'm just trying to cover my bases. Just say I'm just trying to just write in the report that I'm trying to cover all my bases. Okay.
Okay, so I did add that information in there for you.
Mm-hmm. All right, so can you read what you just added?
I can. It states that the caller only drinks while the caller is on the forklift shift because the caller cannot be seen as the caller is above the shelves. The caller usually drinks at work every Friday. The caller takes a sip of alcohol when the caller hears the beep indicating the forklift is going in reverse. The caller stated that this entire report is hypothetical and that the caller is trying to cover the caller's bases.
Can you add at the end, all rights reserved, copyright 2017, like the C symbol?
Okay.
Can you read that back?
It says all rights reserved, the copyright symbol, 2017.
Okay. I think that seems to be it. I guess I'll let you go. And I hope you have a good day.
Thanks, you too. Bye-bye.
All right, bye.